This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Radiation therapy or radiotherapy, often abbreviated RT, RTX, or XRT, is therapy using ionizing radiation, generally as part of cancer treatment to control or kill malignant cells and normally delivered by a linear accelerator. Radiation therapy may be curative in a number of types of cancer if they are localized to one area of the body. It may also be used as part of adjuvant therapy, to prevent tumor recurrence after surgery to remove a primary malignant tumor. For example, early stages of breast cancer radiation therapy is synergistic with chemotherapy, and has been used before, during, and after chemotherapy in susceptible cancers. The subspecialty of oncology that focuses on radiotherapy is called radiation oncology. Radiation therapy is commonly applied to the cancerous tumor because of its ability to control cell growth. Ionizing radiation works by damaging the DNA of cancerous tissue, leading to cellular death to spare normal tissues such as skin or organs, which radiation must pass through to treat the tumor. Shaped radiation beams are aimed from several angles of exposure to intersect at the tumor, providing a much larger absorbed dose there than in the surrounding, healthy tissue besides the tumor itself. The radiation fields may also include the draining lymph nodes if they are clinically or radiologically involved with tumor, or if there is thought to be a risk of subclinical malignant spread, it is necessary to include a margin of normal tissue around the tumor to allow for uncertainties in daily setup and internal tumor motion. These uncertainties can be caused by internal movement, for example, respiration and bladder filling, and movement of external skin marks relative to the tumor position. Radiation oncology is the medical specialty concerned with prescribing radiation, and is distinct from radiology. The use of radiation in medical imaging and diagnosis. Radiation may be prescribed by a radiation oncologist with intent to cure, curative, or for adjuvant therapy. It may also be used as palliative treatment where cure is not possible and the aim is for local disease control or symptomatic relief, or as therapeutic treatment where the therapy has survival benefit and it can be curative. It is also common to combine radiation therapy with surgery, chemotherapy, hormone therapy, immunotherapy, or some mixture of the four. Most common cancer types can be treated with radiation therapy in some way. The precise treatment intent, curative, adjuvant, neoadjuvant, therapeutic, or palliative, will depend on the tumor type, location, and stage, as well as the general health of the patient. Total body irradiation, TBI, is a radiation therapy technique used to prepare the body to receive a bone marrow transplant. Brachytherapy, in which a radiation source is placed inside or next to the area requiring treatment, is another form of radiation therapy that minimizes exposure to healthy tissue during procedures to treat cancers of the breast, prostate, and other organs. Radiation therapy has several applications in non-malignant conditions, such as the treatment of trigeminal neuralgia, acoustic neuromas, severe thyroid eye disease, pterygium pigmented villonodular synovitis, and prevention of keloid scar growth, vascular restenosis, and heterotopic ossification. The use of radiation therapy in non-malignant conditions is limited partly by worries about the risk of radiation-induced cancers. Contents 1. Medical uses 2. Side effects 21. Acute side effects 22. Late side effects 23. Cumulative side effects 24. Effects on reproduction 25. Effects on pituitary system 26. Radiation therapy accidents 3. Use in non-cancerous diseases 4. Technique 41. Mechanism of action 42. Dose 5. Types 51. External beam radiation therapy 511. Conventional external beam radiation therapy 512. Stereotactic radiation 513. Virtual simulation 3-dimensional conformal radiation therapy and intensity modulated radiation therapy 514. Intensity modulated radiation therapy IMRT 515. Volumetric modulated arc therapy VMAT 516. Particle therapy 517. Auger therapy 52. Brachytherapy 53. Intraoperative radiotherapy 531. Rationale 532. IORT in breast cancer 54. Radioisotope therapy 55. Deep inspiration breath hold 6. History 7. See also 8. References 9. Further reading. 10 External links. Medical uses. Different cancers respond to radiation therapy in different ways. The response of a cancer to radiation is described by its radiosensitivity. Highly radiosensitive cancer cells are rapidly killed by modest doses of radiation. These include leukemias, most lymphomas, and germ cell tumors. The majority of epithelial cancers are only moderately radiosensitive, and require a significantly higher dose of radiation, 60 to 70. Treated with curative doses of radiation therapy if they are at an early stage, for example, non-melanoma skin cancer, head and neck cancer, breast cancer, non-small cell lung cancer, cervical cancer, anal cancer, prostate cancer. Metastatic cancers are generally incurable with radiation therapy because it is not possible to treat the whole body before treatment. A CT scan is often performed to identify the tumor and surrounding normal structures. The patient receives small skin marks to guide the placement of treatment field. Patient positioning is crucial at this stage, as the patient will have to be set up in the identical position during treatment. Many patient positioning devices have been developed for this purpose, including masks and cushions which can be molded to the patient. The response of a tumor to radiation therapy is also related to its size due to complex radiobiology. Very large tumors respond less well to radiation than smaller tumors or microscopic disease. Various strategies are used to overcome this effect. The most common technique is surgical resection prior to radiation therapy. This is most commonly seen in the treatment of breast cancer with wide local excision or mastectomy followed by adjuvant radiation therapy. Another method is to shrink the tumor with neoadjuvant chemotherapy prior to radical radiation therapy. A third technique is to enhance the radiosensitivity of the cancer by giving certain drugs during a course of radiation therapy. Examples of radiosensitizing drugs include cisplatin, nemorazole, and cetuximab. The effect of radiotherapy on control of cancer has been shown to be limited to the first 5 years after surgery, particularly for breast cancer. The difference between breast cancer recurrence in patients who receive radiotherapy versus those who don't is seen mostly in the first 2 to 3 years, and no difference is seen after 5 years. This is explained in detail here. Side effects. Radiation therapy is in itself painless. Many low-dose palliative treatments, for example, radiation therapy to bony metastasis, cause minimal or no side effects, although short-term pain flare-up can be experienced in the days following treatment due to edema compressing nerves in the treated area. Higher doses can cause varying side effects during treatment. Acute side effects, in the months or years following treatment. Long-term side effects, or after retreatment. Cumulative side effects. The nature, severity, and longevity of side effects depends on the organs that receive the radiation, the treatment itself, type of radiation, dose, fractionation, concurrent chemotherapy, and the patient. Most side effects are predictable, and expected side effects from radiation are usually limited to the area of the patient's body that is under treatment. Side effects are dose dependent. For example, higher doses of head and neck radiation can be associated with cardiovascular complications, thyroid dysfunction, and pituitary axis dysfunction. Modern radiation therapy aims to reduce side effects to a minimum and to help the patient understand and deal with side effects that are unavoidable. The main side effects reported are fatigue and skin irritation, like a mild to moderate sunburn. The fatigue often sets in during the middle of a course of treatment and can last for weeks after treatment ends. The irritated skin will heal, but may not be as elastic as it was before. Acute side effects. Nausea and vomiting. This is not a general side effect of radiation therapy, and mechanistically is associated only with treatment of the stomach or abdomen, which commonly react a few hours after treatment, or with radiation therapy to certain nausea-producing structures in the head during treatment of certain head and neck tumors, most commonly the vestibules of the inner ears. As with any distressing treatment, some patients vomit immediately during radiotherapy, or even in anticipation of it, but this is considered a psychological response. Nausea for any reason can be treated with antiemetics. Damage to the epithelial surfaces. Epithelial surfaces may sustain damage from radiation therapy depending on the area being treated. This may include the skin, oral mucosa, pharyngeal, bowel mucosa, and ureter. The rates of onset of damage and recovery from it depend upon the turnover rate of epithelial cells. Typically, the skin starts to become pink and sore several weeks into treatment. The reaction may become more severe during the treatment and for up to about 1 week following the end of radiation therapy, and the skin may break down. Although this moist desquamation is uncomfortable, recovery is usually quick. Skin reactions tend to be worse in areas where there are natural folds in the skin, such as underneath the female breast, behind the ear, and in the groin. Mouth, throat, and stomach sores. If the head and neck area is treated, temporary soreness and ulceration commonly commonly occur in the mouth and throat if severe. This can affect swallowing, and the patient may need painkillers and nutritional support food supplements. The esophagus can also become sore if it is treated directly, or if, as commonly occurs, it receives a dose of collateral radiation during treatment of lung cancer. When treating liver malignancies and metastasis, it is possible for collateral radiation to cause gastric, stomach, or duodenal ulcers. This collateral radiation is commonly caused by non-targeted delivery reflux of the radioactive agents being infused. Methods, techniques, and devices are available to lower the occurrence of this type of adverse side effect. Intestinal discomfort. The lower bowel may be treated directly with radiation treatment of rectal or anal cancer, or be exposed by radiation therapy to other pelvic structures. Prostate, bladder, female genital tract. Typical symptoms are soreness, diarrhea, and nausea. Swelling is part of the general inflammation that occurs. Swelling of soft tissues may cause problems during radiation therapy. This is a concern during treatment of brain tumors and brain metastasis, especially where there is pre-existing raised intracranial pressure or where the tumor is causing near total obstruction of a lumen, e.g., trachea or main bronchus. Surgical intervention may be considered prior to treatment with radiation if surgery is deemed unnecessary or inappropriate. The patient may receive steroids during radiation therapy to reduce swelling. Infertility. The gonads, ovaries, and testicles are very sensitive to radiation. They may be unable to produce gametes following direct exposure to most normal treatment doses of radiation. Treatment planning for all body sites is designed to minimize, if not completely exclude, dose to the gonads if they are not the primary area of treatment. Infertility can be efficiently avoided by sparing at least one gonad from radiation. Late side effects. Late side effects occur months to years after treatment and are generally limited to the area that has been treated. They are often due to damage of blood vessels and connective tissue cells. Many late effects are reduced by fractionating treatment into smaller parts. Fibrosis. Tissues which have been irradiated tend to become less elastic over time due to a diffuse scarring process. Epilation. Epilation. Hair loss may occur on any hair-bearing skin with doses above 1. Lymphedema, a condition of localized fluid retention and tissue swelling, can result from damage to the lymphatic system sustained during radiation therapy. It is the most commonly reported complication in breast radiation therapy patients who receive adjuvant axillary radiotherapy following surgery to clear the axillary lymph nodes. Cancer. Radiation is a potential cause of cancer, and secondary malignancies are seen in a very small minority of patients, usually less than 1/1000. It usually occurs 20 to 30 years following treatment, although some hematological malignancies may develop within 5 to 10 years. In the vast majority of cases, this risk is greatly outweighed by the reduction in risk conferred by treating the primary cancer. The cancer occurs within the treated area of the patient. Heart disease. Radiation has potentially excess risk of death from heart disease seen after some past breast cancer. RT regimens. Cognitive decline in cases of radiation applied to the head. Radiation therapy may cause cognitive decline. Cognitive decline was especially apparent in young children, between the ages of 5 to 11. Studies found, for example, that the IQ of 5-year-old children declined each year after treatment by several IQ points. Radiation enteropathy. The gastrointestinal tract can be damaged following abdominal and pelvic radiotherapy. Atrophy, fibrosis, and vascular changes produce malabsorption, diarrhea, steorrhea, and bleeding with bile acid. Diarrhea and vitamin B12 malabsorption, commonly found due to ileal involvement. Pelvic radiation disease includes radiation proctitis, producing bleeding, diarrhea, and urgency, and can also cause radiation cystitis when the bladder is affected. Cumulative side effects. Cumulative effects from this process should not be confused with long-term effects. When short-term effects have disappeared and long-term effects are subclinical, re-radiation can still be problematic. Effects on reproduction. During the first 2 weeks after fertilization, radiation therapy is lethal but not teratogenic. High doses of radiation during pregnancy induce anomalies, impaired growth, and intellectual disability, and there may be an increased risk of childhood leukemia and other tumors in the offspring in males previously having undergone radiotherapy. There appears to be no increase in genetic defects or congenital malformations in their children conceived after therapy. However, the use of assisted reproductive technologies and micromanipulation techniques might Increase this risk effects on pituitary system hypopituitarism commonly develops after radiation therapy for cellular and paracellular neoplasms, extracellular brain tumors, head and neck tumors, and following whole body irradiation for systemic malignancies. Radiation-induced hypopituitarism mainly affects growth hormone and gonadal hormones. In contrast, adrenocorticotrophic hormone ACTH and thyroid-stimulating hormone TSH deficiencies are the least common among people with radiation induced hypopituitarism. Changes in prolactin secretion is usually mild, and vasopressin deficiency appears to be very rare as a consequence of radiation. Radiation therapy accidents. There are rigorous procedures in place to minimize the risk of accidental overexposure of radiation therapy to patients. However, mistakes do occasionally occur. For example, the radiation therapy machine Theric 25 was responsible for at least 6 accidents between 1985 and 1987, where patients were given up to 100 times the intended dose. 2 people were killed directly by the radiation overdoses from 2005 to 2010. A hospital in Missouri overexposed 76 patients, most with brain cancer, during a 5-year period because new radiation equipment had been set up incorrectly. Although medical errors are exceptionally rare, radiation oncologists, medical physicists, and other members of the radiation therapy treatment team are working to eliminate them. Astro has launched a safety initiative called Target Safely that, among other things, aims to record errors nationwide so that doctors can learn from each and every mistake and prevent them from happening. Astro also publishes a list of questions for patients to ask their doctors about radiation safety to ensure every treatment is as safe as possible. Use in non-cancerous diseases. The beam's eye view of the radiotherapy portal on the hand's surface with the lead shield cutout placed in the machine's gantry. Radiation therapy is used to treat early-stage Dupuytren's disease and Lederhose disease when Dupuytren's disease is at the nodules and cords stage or fingers are at a minimal deformation stage of less than 10 degrees, then radiation therapy is used to prevent further progress of the disease. Radiation therapy is also used post-surgery in some cases to prevent the disease continuing to progress. Low doses of radiation are used, typically 3 gray of radiation for 5 days, with a break of 3 months followed by another phase of 3 gray of radiation for 5 days. Technique. Mechanism of action. Radiation therapy works by damaging the DNA of cancerous cells. This DNA damage is caused by one of 2 types of energy, photon or charged particle. This damage is either direct or indirect ionization of the atoms which make up the DNA chain. Indirect ionization happens as a result of the ionization of water, forming free radicals, notably hydroxyl radicals, which then damage the DNA. In photon therapy, most of the radiation effect is through free radical cells have mechanisms for repairing single-strand DNA damage and double-stranded DNA damage. However, double-stranded DNA breaks are much more difficult to repair, and can lead to dramatic chromosomal abnormalities and genetic deletions. Targeting double-stranded breaks increases the probability that cells will undergo cell death. Cancer cells are generally less differentiated and more stem cell-like. They reproduce more than most healthy differentiated cells, and have a diminished ability to repair sub-lethal damage. Single-strand DNA damage is then passed on through cell division. Damage to the cancer cell's DNA accumulates, causing them to die or reproduce more slowly. One of the major limitations of photon radiation therapy is that the cells of solid tumors become deficient in oxygen. Solid tumors can outgrow their blood supply, causing a low oxygen state known as hypoxia. Oxygen is a potent radiosensitizer, increasing the effectiveness of a given dose of radiation by forming DNA damaging free radicals. Tumor cells in a hypoxic environment may be as much as 2 to 3 times more resistant to radiation damage than those in a normal oxygen environment. Much research has been devoted to overcoming hypoxia, including the use of high-pressure oxygen tanks, hyperthermia therapy, heat therapy which dilates blood vessels to the tumor site, blood substitutes that carry increased oxygen, hypoxic cell radiosensitizer drugs such as misinidazole and metronidazole, and hypoxic cytotoxins. Tissue poisons, such as tirapazamine. Newer research approaches are currently being studied, including preclinical and clinical investigations into the use use of an oxygen diffusion-enhancing compound such as trans-sodium crocidinate TSC as a radiosensitizer. Charged particles such as protons and boron, carbon, and neon ions can cause direct damage to cancer cell DNA through high-let linear energy transfer and have an anti-tumor effect independent of tumor oxygen supply because these particles act mostly via direct energy transfer, usually causing double-stranded DNA breaks due to their relatively large mass. Protons and other charged particles have little lateral side scatter in the tissue, the beam does not broaden much, stays focused on the tumor shape, and delivers small dose side effects to surrounding tissue. They also more precisely target the tumor using the Bragg peak effect. See proton therapy for a good example of the different effects of intensity modulated radiation therapy IMRT versus charged particle therapy. This procedure reduces damage to healthy tissue between the charged particle radiation source and the tumor and sets a finite range for tissue damage after the tumor has been reached. In contrast, IMRT's use of uncharged particles causes its energy to damage healthy cells when it exits the body. This exiting damage is not therapeutic, can increase treatment side effects, and increases the probability of secondary cancer induction. This difference is very important in cases where the close proximity of other organs makes any stray ionization very damaging. Example, head and neck cancers. This X-ray exposure is especially bad for children, due to their growing bodies, and they have a 30% chance of a second malignancy after 5 years post initial RT dose. The amount of radiation used in photon radiation therapy is measured in gray GY, and varies depending on the type and stage of cancer being treated. For curative cases, the typical dose for a solid epithelial tumor ranges from 60 to 80. Treatment planning software. Depending on the radiation delivery method, several angles or sources may be used to sum to the total necessary dose. The planner will try to design a plan that delivers a uniform prescription dose to the tumor and minimizes dose to surrounding healthy tissues. In radiation therapy, three-dimensional dose distributions are often evaluated using the dosimetry technique known as gel dosimetry fractionation. This section only applies to photon RT, although other types of radiation therapy may be fractionated. The total dose is fractionated spread out over time for several important reasons. Fractionation allows normal cells time to recover, while tumor cells are generally less efficient in repair between fractions. Fractionation also allows tumor cells that were in a relatively radio-resistant phase of the cell cycle during one treatment to cycle into a sensitive phase of the cycle before the next fraction is given. Similarly, tumor cells that were chronically or acutely hypoxic and therefore more radio-resistant may reoxygenate between fractions. Improving the tumor cell kill. Fractionation regimens are individualized between different radiation therapy centers and even between individual doctors in North America, Australia, and Europe. The typical fractionation schedule for adults is 18-2. Types. Prolongation of the fraction schedule over too long can allow for the tumor to begin repopulating, and for these tumor types, including head and neck and cervical squamous cell cancers, radiation treatment is preferably completed within a certain amount of time. For children, a typical fraction size may be 15-18.20. Slowly deliver radiation until they become inactive. Types. Historically, the three main divisions of radiation therapy are external beam radiation therapy, EBRT or XRT or teletherapy, brachytherapy or sealed source radiation therapy, and systemic radioisotope therapy or unsealed source radiotherapy. The differences relate to the position of the radiation source. External is outside the body. Brachytherapy uses sealed radioactive sources placed precisely in the area under treatment, and systemic radioisotopes are given by infusion or oral ingestion. Brachytherapy can use temporary or permanent placement of radioactive sources. The temporary sources are usually placed by a technique called afterloading. In afterloading, a hollow tube or applicator is placed surgically in the organ to be treated, and the sources are loaded into the applicator after the applicator is implanted. This minimizes radiation exposure to healthcare personnel. Particle therapy is a special case of external beam radiation therapy where the particles are protons or heavier ions. Intraoperative radiation therapy or IORT is a special type of radiation therapy that is delivered immediately after surgical removal of the cancer. This method has been employed in breast cancer, targeted intraoperative radiation therapy or TARGIT, brain tumors, and rectal cancers. External beam radiation therapy Main article, External Beam Radiation Therapy. The following three sections refer to treatment using X-rays. Conventional External Beam Radiation Therapy, a teletherapy radiation capsule composed of the following: an international standard source holder, usually lead, BA retaining ring, and CA teletherapy source composed of D2 nested stainless steel canisters welded to E2 stainless steel lids surrounding FA protective internal shield, usually uranium metal or a tungsten alloy, and GA cylinder of radioactive source material, often but not always cobalt-60. The diameter of the source is 30. Usually well-established arrangements of the radiation beams to achieve a desired plan. The aim of simulation is to accurately target or localize the volume which is to be treated. This technique is well-established and is generally quick and reliable. The worry is that some high-dose treatments may be limited by the radiation toxicity capacity of healthy tissues which lie close to the target tumor volume. An example of this problem is seen in radiation of the prostate gland, where the sensitivity of the adjacent rectum limited the dose which could be safely prescribed using 2DXRT planning to such an extent that tumor control may not be easily achievable. Prior to the invention of the CT, physicians and physicists had limited knowledge about the true radiation dosage delivered to both cancerous and healthy tissue. For this reason, three-dimensional conformal radiation therapy is becoming the standard treatment for a number of tumor sites. More recently, other forms of imaging are used, including MRI, PET, SPECT, and ultrasound stereotactic radiation. Main article, Radiosurgery. Stereotactic radiation is a specialized type of external beam radiation therapy. It uses focused radiation beams targeting a well-defined tumor using extremely detailed imaging scans. Radiation oncologists perform stereotactic treatments, often with the help of a neurosurgeon, for tumors in the brain or spine. There are two types of stereotactic radiation. Stereotactic radiosurgery, SRS, is when doctors use a single or several stereotactic radiation treatments of the brain or spine. Stereotactic body radiation therapy, SBRT, refers to one or several stereotactic radiation treatments with the body, such as the lungs. Some doctors say an advantage to stereotactic treatments is that they deliver the right amount of radiation to the cancer in a shorter amount of time than traditional treatments, which can often take 6 to 11 weeks plus. Treatments are given with extreme accuracy, which should limit the effect of the radiation on healthy tissues. One problem with stereotactic treatments is that they are only suitable for certain small tumors. Stereotactic treatments can be confusing because many hospitals call the treatments by the name of the manufacturer rather than calling it SRS or SBRT. Brand names for these treatments include Axis, Cyberknife, Gamma Knife, Novalis, Primatom, Synergy, X-Knife, Tomotherapy, Trilogy, and TrueBeam. This list changes as equipment manufacturers continue to develop new, specialized technologies to treat cancers. Virtual simulation, three-dimensional conformal radiation therapy, and intensity-modulated radiation therapy. The planning of radiation therapy treatment has been revolutionized by the ability to delineate tumors and adjacent normal structures in three dimensions using specialized CT and/or MRI scanners and planning software. Virtual simulation, the most basic form of planning, allows more accurate placement of radiation beams than is possible using conventional X-rays, where soft tissue structures are often difficult to assess and normal tissues difficult to protect. An enhancement of virtual simulation is three-dimensional conformal radiation therapy, 3D CRT, in which the profile of each radiation beam is shaped to fit the profile of the target from a beam's eye view. BEV, using a multileaf column MLC and a variable number of beams. When the treatment volume conforms to the shape of the tumor, the relative toxicity of radiation to the surrounding normal tissues is reduced, allowing a higher dose of radiation to be delivered to the tumor than conventional techniques would allow. Intensity modulated radiation therapy, IMRT. Intensity modulated radiation therapy, IMRT, is an advanced type of high precision radiation that is the next generation of 3D CRT. IMRT also improves the ability to conform the treatment volume to concave tumor shapes, for example when the tumor is wrapped around a vulnerable structure such as the spinal cord or a major organ or blood vessel. Computer-controlled X-ray accelerators distribute precise radiation doses to malignant tumors or specific areas within the tumor. The pattern of radiation delivery is determined using highly tailored computing applications to perform optimization and treatment simulation. Treatment Planning the radiation dose is consistent with the 3D shape of the tumor by controlling, or modulating, the radiation beam's intensity. The radiation dose intensity is elevated near the gross tumor volume while radiation among the neighboring normal tissues is decreased or avoided completely. This results in better tumor targeting, lessened side effects, and improved treatment outcomes than even 3D CRT. 3D CRT is still used extensively for many body sites, but the use of IMRT is growing in more complicated body sites such as CNS, head and neck, prostate, breast, and lung. Unfortunately, IMRT is limited by its need for additional time from experienced medical personnel. This is because physicians must manually delineate the tumor's one CT image at a time through the entire disease site, which can take much longer than 3D CRT preparation. Then, medical physicists and dosimetrists must be engaged to create a viable treatment plan. Also, the IMRT technology has only been used commercially since the late 1990s, even at the most advanced cancer centers, so radiation oncologists who did not learn it as part of their residency programs must find additional sources of education before implementing IMRT. Proof of improved survival benefit from either of these two techniques over conventional radiation therapy. 2DXRT is growing for many tumor sites, but the ability to reduce toxicity is generally accepted. This is particularly the case for head and neck cancers in a series of pivotal trials performed by Professor Christopher Nutting of the Royal Marsden Hospital. Both techniques enable dose escalation, potentially increasing usefulness. There has been some concern, particularly with IMRT, about increased exposure of normal tissue to radiation and the consequent potential for secondary malignancy. Overconfidence in the accuracy of imaging may increase the chance of missing lesions that are invisible on the planning scans and therefore not included in the treatment plan, or that move between or during a treatment, for example, due to respiration or inadequate patient immobilization. New techniques are being developed to better control this uncertainty, for example, real-time imaging combined with real-time adjustment of the therapeutic beams. This new technology is called image-guided radiation therapy, IGRT, or four-dimensional radiation therapy. Another technique is the real-time tracking and localization of one or more small implantable electric devices implanted inside or close to the tumor. There are various types of medical implantable devices that are used for this purpose. It can be a magnetic transponder, which senses the magnetic field generated by several transmitting coils, and then transmits the measurements back to the positioning system to determine the location. The implantable device can also be a small wireless transmitter sending out an RF signal, which then will be received by a sensor array and used for localization and real-time tracking of the tumor position. Volumetric modulated arc therapy, VMAT. Volumetric modulated arc therapy, VMAT, is a new radiation technique, which can achieve highly conformal dose distributions on target volume coverage and sparing of normal tissues. The specificity of this technique is to modify the three parameters during the treatment. VMAT delivers radiation by rotating gantry, usually 360 degrees rotating fields with one or more arcs, changing speed and shape of the beam with a multileaf collimator MLC sliding window system of moving and fluence. Output rate, dose rate of the medical linear accelerator. VMAT also has the potential to give additional advantages in patient treatment, such as reduced delivery time of radiation, compared with conventional static field intensity modulated radiotherapy. IMRT particle therapy. Main article, particle therapy. In particle therapy, proton therapy being one example, energetic ionizing particles, protons or carbon ions, are directed at the target tumor. The dose increases while the particle penetrates the tissue, up to a maximum, the Bragg peak that occurs near the end of the particle's range, and it then drops to almost zero. The advantage of this energy deposition profile is that less energy is deposited into the healthy tissue surrounding the target tissue. Auger therapy. Main article, Auger therapy. Auger therapy, it makes use of a very high dose of ionizing radiation in situ that provides molecular modifications at an atomic scale. It differs from conventional radiation therapy in several aspects. It neither relies upon radioactive nuclei to cause cellular radiation damage at a cellular dimension, nor engages multiple external pencil beams from different directions to zero in to deliver a dose to the targeted area with reduced dose outside the targeted tissue. Organ location. applications instead. The in situ delivery of a very high dose at the molecular level using it aims for in situ molecular modifications involving molecular breakages and molecular rearrangements, such as a change of stacking structures as well as cellular metabolic functions related to the said molecule structures. Brachytherapy. Main article: Brachytherapy. A savvy brachytherapy device. Brachytherapy seeds used to treat prostate cancer. Brachytherapy. Internal radiation therapy is delivered by placing radiation sources inside or next to the area requiring treatment. Brachytherapy is commonly used as an effective treatment for cervical, prostate, breast, and skin cancer, and can also be used to treat tumors in many other body sites, as with stereotactic radiation. Brachytherapy treatments are often known by their brand names. For example, brand names for breast cancer brachytherapy treatments include Savvy, Mamacyte, and Contra. Brand names for prostate cancer include Proxelin, Theracide, and Iceide. In brachytherapy, radiation sources are precisely placed directly at the site of the cancerous tumor. This means that the irradiation only affects a very localized area. Exposure to radiation of healthy tissues further away from the sources is reduced. These characteristics of brachytherapy provide advantages over external beam radiation therapy. The tumor can be treated with very high doses of localized radiation, whilst reducing the probability of unnecessary damage to surrounding healthy tissues. A course of brachytherapy can often be completed in less time than other radiation therapy techniques. This can help reduce the chance of surviving cancer cells dividing and growing in the intervals between each radiation therapy dose. As one example of the localized nature of breast brachytherapy, the Savvy device delivers the radiation dose through multiple catheters, each of which can be individually controlled. This approach decreases the exposure of healthy tissue and resulting side effects, compared both to external beam radiation therapy and older methods of breast brachytherapy. Intraoperative radiotherapy. It has been suggested that this article be merged into intraoperative radiation therapy. Discuss proposed since May 2016. Intraoperative radiation therapy IORT is applying therapeutic levels of radiation to a target area, such as a cancer tumor, while the area is exposed during surgery. The goal of IORT is to improve local tumor control and survival rates for patients with different types of cancer. Rationale. The rationale for IORT is to deliver a high dose of radiation precisely to the targeted area with minimal exposure of surrounding tissues, which are displaced or shielded during the IORT. Conventional radiation techniques such as external beam radiotherapy EBRT following surgical removal of the tumor have several drawbacks. The tumor bed where the highest dose should be applied is frequently missed due to the complex localization of the wound cavity, even when modern radiotherapy planning is used. Additionally, the usual delay between the surgical removal of the tumor and EBRT may allow a repopulation of the tumor cells. These potentially harmful effects can be avoided by delivering the radiation more precisely to the targeted tissues, leading to immediate sterilization of residual tumor cells. Another aspect is that wound fluid has a stimulating effect on tumor cells. IORT was found to inhibit the stimulating effects of wound fluid IORT in breast cancer. The largest experience with IORT and the best evidence for its potentials exists in breast cancer, where a substantial number of patients have already been treated using, for example, the TARGIT targeted intraoperative radiotherapy technique. Targeted intraoperative radiotherapy TARGIT IORT for breast cancer. On the 11th of November 2013, the 5-year results of local recurrence and overall survival from the TARGIT, a trial of TARGIT IORT for breast cancer, were published in The Lancet. 3,451 patients from 33 centers in 11 countries participated in the trial. The analysis of the data found that with longer follow-up, the results are stable. Local recurrence in the conserved breast with TARGIT concurrent with lumpectomy is similar to whole breast radiotherapy. Breast cancer mortality is similar with TARGIT and EBRT, and deaths from causes other than breast cancer, cardiovascular and other cancers, are significantly reduced. The conclusion was that TARGIT concurrent with lumpectomy within a risk-adapted approach should be considered as an option for eligible patients with breast cancer carefully selected as per the TARGIT a trial protocol, as an alternative to postoperative EBRT. The results of TARGIT TARGIT IORT for breast cancer are discussed in a podcast of the TARGIT and Elliott Trials on the Lancet website. Full TARGITIORT paper. Radioisotope therapy main article. Unsealed source. Radiotherapy. Systemic radioisotope therapy. RIT is a form of targeted therapy. Targeting can be due to the chemical properties of the isotope, such as radioiodine, which is specifically absorbed by the thyroid gland a thousandfold better than other bodily organs. Targeting can also be achieved by attaching the radioisotope to another molecule or antibody to guide it to the target tissue. The radioisotopes are delivered through infusion into the bloodstream or ingestion. Examples are the infusion of methiodobenzylguanidine MIBG to treat neuroblastoma, of oral iodine 131 to treat thyroid cancer or thyrotoxicosis, and of hormone-bound lutetium 177 and yttrium 90 to treat neuroendocrine tumors. Peptide receptor radionuclide therapy. Another example is the injection of yttrium 90 radioactive glass or resin microspheres into the hepatic artery to radioembolize liver tumors or liver metastasis. These microspheres are used for the treatment approach known as selective internal radiation therapy. The microspheres are approximately 30. Tumor enabling a more selective approach than traditional systemic chemotherapy. There are currently two different kinds of microspheres, SIR spheres and therosphere. A major use of systemic radioisotope therapy is in the treatment of bone metastasis from cancer. The radioisotopes travel selectively to areas of damaged bone, and spare normal undamaged bone. Isotopes commonly used in the treatment of bone metastasis are strontium-89 and samarium-153 SM lexidronium. In 2002, the United States Food and Drug Administration FDA approved ibritomomab tigzetin zevalin, which is an anti-CD20 monoclonal antibody conjugated to yttrium 90. In 2003, the FDA approved the toshitumomab iodine 131 itoshitumomab regimen Bexxar, which is a combination of an iodine 131 labeled and an unlabeled anti-CD20 monoclonal antibody. These medications were the first agents of what is known as radioimmunotherapy, and they were approved for the treatment of refractory non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Deep inspiration breath hold. Deep inspiration breath hold DIBH is a method of delivering radiotherapy while limiting radiation exposure to the heart and lungs. It is used primarily for treating left-sided breast cancer. The technique involves a patient holding their breath during treatment. There are two basic methods of performing DIBH: free breathing breath hold and spirometry monitored deep inspiration breath hold. History. X-ray treatment of tuberculosis in 1910. Before the 1920s, the hazards of radiation were not understood, and it was used to treat a wide range of diseases. Main article, History of Radiation Therapy. Medicine has used radiation therapy as a treatment for cancer for more than 100 years, with its earliest roots traced from the discovery of X-rays in 1895 by Wilhelm Röntgen. Emil Grubb of Chicago was possibly the first American physician to use X-rays to treat cancer. Beginning in 1896, the field of radiation therapy began to grow in the early 1900s, largely due to the groundbreaking work of Nobel Prize-winning scientist Marie Curie (1867–1934), who discovered the radioactive elements polonium and radium in 1898. This began a new era in medical treatment and research. Through the 1920s, the hazards of radiation exposure were not understood, and little protection was used. Radium was believed to have wide curative powers, and radiotherapy was applied to many diseases. Prior to World War II, the only practical sources of radiation for radiotherapy were radium and its emanation, radon gas, and the X-ray tube. External beam radiotherapy. Teletherapy began at the turn of the century with relatively low voltage. Higher energy beams were required to reach tumors inside the body, requiring higher voltages. Orthovoltage X-rays, which used tube voltages of 200 to 500. Cobalt units in the 1980s, and these older therapies are now declining. The first medical linear accelerator was used at the Hammersmith Hospital in London in 1953. Linear accelerators can produce higher energies, have more collimated beams, and do not produce radioactive waste with its attendant disposal problems like radioisotope therapies. With Godfrey Hounsfield's invention of computed tomography CT in 1971, three-dimensional planning became a possibility and created a shift from 2D to 3D. 3D radiation delivery CT-based planning allows physicians to more accurately determine the dose distribution using axial tomographic images of the patient's anatomy. The advent of new imaging technologies, including magnetic resonance imaging MRI in the 1970s and positron emission tomography PET in the 1980s, has moved radiation therapy from 3D conformal to intensity-modulated radiation therapy IMRT and to image-guided radiation therapy IGRT tomotherapy. These advances allowed radiation oncologists to better see and target tumors, which have resulted in better treatment outcomes, more organ preservation and fewer side effects. See also cancer and nausea. Fast neutron therapy. Neutron capture therapy of cancer particle beam. Radiation therapist selective internal radiation therapy treatment of cancer. References: Carrot, C.K. Bomford, I.H. Kunkler, J. Walter Walter and Miller's Textbook of Radiation Therapy 6th ed. p. 311. Carrot, radiosensitivity on GP notebook http://oop/notebook/simplepagekefemid=206045185.3. Carrot, radiation therapy what GPs need to know on patient cook http://patientinfo/doctor/radiotherapy. Carrot, Mavrakis E., Cornelius L. A., Bowen G. M., Fan T., Patel F. B., Fitzmaurice S., He Y., Burl B., Duong C., Clarkson A. M., Sultani H., Wilkin R., Martinez Sr., Patel F. 2015. Metastatic melanoma, a review of current and future treatment options. Acta Derm Venereal 95-5-516-524 doi:102340-0015555-2035 PMID.